Grand Theft Auto San Andreas on the PC, because I played on the PC. This game really has it all. Racing, shooting, pimping, biking, shopping, piloting fire planes, exercising, real estate investing, gambling, smoking weed, of course, and even politics. And of course, lots and lots of controversy, from naughty words to even naughtier deeds. When you play this game, the first thing you'll probably be thinking is, wow, only in fucking America. And indeed, this is an American game. You feel it throughout. The sheer freedom offered in the gameplay, the insane amount of violence, the conflicting and often hypocritical race ideologies, they all make for a game that is very American in flavor. For some, it may be a bit too much to handle. But for us GTA fans, it's easily one of the best fucking games ever made. One of the most impressive things about this game has to do with the dialogue and the voice acting. It's phenomenal, especially considering that many of the characters are voiced by famous Hollywood actors, from Ice Cube to Samuel L. Jackson. The cast does an incredible job of portraying the African-American dynamics in California, most notably in Los Angeles. The other races add an interesting flavor to the overall story, even if some of them are too over the top, like the Vietnamese-Chinese gang rivalry that takes place near the end of the game. It's not a realistic portrayal, but it's not necessarily a stereotypical presentation either, although sometimes it can be. Everything from Ebonics to the hippie drug culture to the Asian Confucian mentality is flawlessly presented. This game may be lacking an engaging story. It is a sandbox game. You can't really expect too much story out of that genre. But it makes up for it by having believable ethnic interactions and a script that belongs more in a film like Boys in the Hood than in a video game. Seriously, I mean, honestly, this game is everything you can imagine jam-packed into one single game. Nearly every race is represented in the game. All kinds of characters are here. A black cop who doesn't solve crimes but instead causes more crimes for his own financial benefit. A white FBI agent that uses a criminal to achieve shit that is too much controversial for the federal government to admit doing. A Hispanic woman who likes being the dominant one during intercourse. And by dominant, I'm talking about whips, knives, and axes here. A blind Chinese gang leader who wants to establish the number one casino in Las Venturas, which is the game's version of Las Vegas, even if it means killing some Italian mafia members in Liberty City. The amount of different characters makes this game very interesting and sometimes shocking. There's a lot of shock value to the cutscenes, and throughout this game, I never wanted to skip any cutscene, because it was just so entertaining to watch from beginning to the end. It actually is cohesive in some moments as well, because there's betrayals, there's interesting plot twists in here and there, and just so many damn interesting characters. I mentioned like 5 of them so far, but I could name like 10 more characters that are so freaking crazy and so memorable. Beyond the diverse cast of characters, the game is really all about the gameplay. You can swim and collect hidden clamshells under the sea. You can create graffiti on the walls as a sign of your gang's territorial prowess. You can pilot helicopters and planes. You can drive vehicles ranging from motorcycles to sedans to big rigs to construction vehicles. It's pretty diverse. And while driving those vehicles, if you're equipped with a submachine gun, you can also do a drive-by and cause gang wars. You can beat the shit out of a random pedestrian with a club to steal what little cash they have in their pockets. And all this is just the tip of the iceberg in this game. You'll be doing so many different shit in this game that the replay value of the game is really beyond what any other kind of game offers, especially in this genre. Some missions can have repetitive elements, like, must I really kill waves and waves of those gangbanging motherfuckers again and again just to kill a little more gain a little more gang territory? But the game as a whole always feels fresh. There's also a number of new ideas that have been implemented in GTA San Andreas that have never been seen before in the previous GTA titles. The first thing, of course, are the new areas Los Santos, San Fierro, and Las Venturas, fictional series resembling Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Las Vegas, respectively. But other than the obvious geographic change is the upgradable skill system. The more kills you rack up with your AK, the better your assault rifle skills become. The more often you lift weights in your local gym, the more muscular you become, and thus the stronger you become. There are a lot of skills like this, and while they're a bit simplistic, upgrading some of the skills are very satisfactory. I do have to mention, though, that upgrading gun skills on the PC version of San Andreas is kind of useless, because aiming is already kind of perfect with the mouse of the PC version. And no matter how skilled at shooting your character becomes, shooting ultimately depends on how you aim with your mouse, not on your skill gauge. And with the mouse, it's just so damn easy to get headshots, which isn't the case with the PS2 or the Xbox version. But one thing good about the PS2 and Xbox version is that after you max out your skill, your gun skills, you get a triangle thingy, you get the lock on, and you shoot, and it's automatic headshot, so you don't even have to aim. So it makes it, I guess, more convenient. So it, in a way, it is kind of a shame that the PC version threw that away, threw away the skill system for weapons, but being able to use mouse is ultimately more precise option overall. The other new feature in the game is the Gang Wars feature. Your character is actually a member of one of the three gangs in San Andreas. As a member, it's your job to defend your gang's turf and obtain more territory for your gang by inciting gang wars and winning them. Every gang member wears their own colors. You start a gang war by killing three or more of rival gang members in an area. When you do that, the rival gang members will come to kill you. If you survive, you win the territory, and this constant war will be a major part of the game as well as the game story. And then there's the minor addition of relationship building gameplay. You can take girl out on a date to certain areas, and the more successful dates you have, the closer you come to getting into her pants. There's a level gauge that shows your relationship progress, and it's funny that you could do this with multiple girls at the same time, being a true playa. But it's not easy. Whether a date will be successful or not sometimes feels a bit too random, and your date sometimes doesn't show up on your radar, and so it's often hard to go back to your girlfriend's house because you don't have a clue where it is. This feature could have been better implemented, and it just feels kinda tacked on at times. One of the missions requires you to get to a 50% relationship progress with the girl in order to get access to her house and steal the key. Since the dating system was so hard, that mission was a pain in the ass, and I was glad not to ever have to date in the game again. But anywho, as far as the remaining features go, they feel perfected. The game still focuses on details like flat tires affecting vehicle performance, awesome radio station and cars, diverse NPCs roaming around the streets, and police reaction to your criminal actions. And it's just all great. A lot of it could still be a lot better, but since the game has such large scope of gameplay and presentation, it's easily forgivable and forgettable. I haven't mentioned hardly any bad thing about this game, and honestly, I can't really think of much more than what I've already mentioned. I don't know, maybe the fact that this game doesn't have online multiplayer, the shooting mechanics feel a too arcadey. I'm putting these as questions because these things did not hurt the game at all. But anyway, look, this is a game where you can end up eating too much fast food, and obesity will affect your performance in the game. I mean, holy shit, can you really think of another game like that? Not even MGS3 Snake Eater has that kind of gameplay element. Also, the amount of licensed soundtrack from popular artists of the 80s, including this game, is really unbeatable. There are some artists that I wish this game had, like Guns N' Roses, Tupac, and Public Enemy, but alas, the list of artists and songs in this game is really awesome. And the radio talk show in this game is really hilarious. It may not be politically incorrect as a chatterbox in GTA 3, but alas, when you set your car's radio station to the talk show, there'd be a lot of times where you'd just be laughing from the outrageous commercials, or from an interview guest boasting how misogynistic he is, and how he's been debasing women since he was a kid. Such uncensored humor can only be found in GTA games, and GTA San Andreas is more of what makes GTA games great. This game takes everything that's considered wrong by society, like cocaine, prostitution, cop killing, gang wars, governmental corruption, and makes it into an incredibly fun and addictive video game experience. If you ask me, I mean, personally for me, this is the best GTA game ever made, and beyond that, it's one of the best video games ever made, and beyond that, it's also one of the best entertainment products ever made. So for me, it really is that awesome of a game.